You can use the Scenario Manager in Excel to compare how your results can change based on changes to the values being calculated. So let's say that this purchase price changes based on how many items are bought. So we can create different what-if scenarios to compare the results. And you'll find the Scenario Manager in the Data tab in the Forecast section under What-If Analysis. So right now, we don't have any scenarios, so we need to create one. To create a scenario, click Add. Next, we need to give our scenario a name. So this first scenario will be for buying a quantity of 50. So we'll call it Buying 50. Next, we need to select the cells that we want to change the values for in the scenario. So in this example, we're only going to change the values for these two cells. But know that you can select up to 32 different cells to change the value for, and add a more specific comment if you like, and click OK. In this next screen, we'll enter the values that we want to use to calculate the scenario. And this first scenario is going to be exactly what's on the screen right now. So the first cell, B1, which is quantity bought, will be 50, and B2, which is the price, will be 30. And at this point, you can click OK or click Add to add another scenario, which is what we're going to do. So we'll click Add. Our next scenario will be for buying a quantity of 75. So we'll call it Buying 75. The cells we want changed are the same cells. So we'll move on and click OK. But this time we want to change the quantity bought from 50 to 75. And the price is going to change from 30 to 25. And we'll click OK. So now we're back at the main Scenario Manager screen. And from here, you can select any of your scenarios and click Show to see the alternate values populate on your spreadsheet. And you can click back and forth, toggling through them so you can compare. You also have the option to add more scenarios if you want to delete or edit any of these scenarios. You can also merge the selected scenario with another scenario. Just make sure that they're formatted the same. And here, if you click on Summary, Excel will create a summary of all your scenarios next to each other so that you can compare them. You can do this in a scenario summary form, which kind of resembles a table, but it'll be grouped, or as a pivot table where you can move the fields around how you like. But I'm going to select scenario summary. So a couple of important things here. First, the scenario summary is not linked to your data. So any changes that you make to your data will not be reflected here. And also, by default, the scenario summary displays the cell references as the labels. So to avoid this, you can assign a named range to each of your values. So let's go back to our values. To do this, you can name them one at a time, or if you don't mind them using the same name as your labels, you can name them all at the same time. So to do it this way, you'll want to make sure that your column labels are adjacent to your values and select both your columns, and in your Formulas tab, under Define Names, click on Create from Selection. Make sure left column is checked off and click OK. Now, if we go back to the Scenario Manager and let's click on Edit, click OK. Notice that now the scenario values have new names. They're not displaying the cell references anymore. And if you create a new summary, you'll see the new name labels here too. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.